There's drama on the track and off the track. Ricky Thornton Jr. got into Chris Madden multiple times during the race on Saturday night at the World Finals at the dirt track at Charlotte, which seemingly stemmed from contact that was made on Friday night from Madden against Ricky Thornton Jr. And it all seemed to boil over following the race, which Chris Madden won and Ricky Thornton Jr. finished in second, as security had to be called to separate Ricky Thornton Jr. from the team of Chris Madden. I wrote this up over at stockcarreport.com. You can find the link in the description below if you'd like to read the article yourself. So let's just jump into this here. Madden took home the win after passing Thornton on the third lap of the 50-lap feature. Was not really challenged after that. I mean, Thornton did try to challenge him a couple of times following that, but cautions didn't really fall his way. As soon as he was able to kind of like challenge him, a caution would come out and Madden would be able to take the lead and then kind of jet off and go unchallenged. And so he took home the lead. Thornton seemingly did not take too kindly to how Madden passed him and immediately gave him a shot to the left rear quarter panel, obviously on that lap three. So let's just take a look at this right here. This is over on the World of Outlaws official YouTube page. So you can see some of their highlights here, and this was included.
He can seal the deal down the back straightaway. Chris Smokey Madden to the race lead. Him and Thornton have raced each other pretty hard all.
So there you go. Obviously, Madden looks like he does a clean pass on Thornton there. Thornton probably not really happy about what happened on Friday night, which we will get to here in a little bit. Gives Madden a shot in the left rear quarter panel there. Obviously, breaks his momentum, has him drift up the track, and he loses a position here to Bobby Pierce. But he would get that back as Bob Pierce would suffer a flat right rear, I believe. And then later on in the race, during our longest green flag run right here. Let me back it up real quick. longest green flag run would look like we were actually going to get a really good race for the lead there. And Ricky Thornton Jr. just gave Madden another shot in that left rear quarter panel here. Let's take a look.
Brandon Shepherd on your screen in the B5. Ricky Thornton Jr. contact with a 44 of Madden. The gloves off again, and now Mike Marler able to get around.
So you can see right there, again, same kind of thing happened. Thornton gave Madden a shot after tracking him down and then had to, like, obviously woe it up. That allowed Marler to seemingly get around him, but then the caution came out and they re-racked the field, and Madden was completely unchallenged after that. So that is what happened on the track Saturday night. This is what happened following the race. Thornton was asked by Dirt Vision's Hannah Newhouse what he could have done in order to win, and this is what he said. I guess guys quit throwing yellows or whatever the hell they were doing around the top. I don't know if they were blowing tires or what, but I feel like every time we get a little bit of a run, we get a yellow, of course, right when we get to traffic. He then appeared to direct his ire towards Madden. He said this: I don't know, second left side he needs. I guess he needs them more than I do, so hopefully he goes to Sonoya next week. We'll take care of it. So Ricky clearly unhappy with Madden, talking about the fact that I guess Madden used him up or something like that. I didn't really understand what he was referencing here. If someone understands that, please let me know in the comments below. I didn't really get it even when I listened to it last night. Still don't really get it here, but clearly he is says he's going to handle business if Madden does indeed go to the Castrol Flow Racing season finale at Sonoya next week, which should be an excellent, excellent event. I'm looking forward to that. So as I said earlier, they did have a run-in during Friday night's feature. Let's just take a look at it right here.
Or just a little bit. That allows for Madden to go three wide. Trouble Thornton sideways. Somehow keeps it straight. Here comes Davenport to the inside of Madden. The gloves are off.
So there you go. Obviously, you can see there that Thornton found himself on the top of three right there. Madden in the middle. Ethan Dotson on the bottom. And Madden got into Thornton's door, got him all sideways. I mean, he was basically perpendicular to the track. Absolutely amazing job at being able to save it. And then obviously Madden had to check up too. And then he played a little bit of bumper cars there, pinball, whatever you want to call it, with Jonathan Davenport. It's kind of bounced off his door coming out of the corner there. So that could be where a lot of this stems from. There could be also something else happening, because obviously we do know that Madden was the crew chief for Ricky Thornton Jr. They both won the Lucas Oil Late Model Dirt Series. So maybe there is something that hasn't been reported or we don't really know about. Maybe there's some like personal animosity or something behind the scenes that happened. Maybe these two guys just don't like each other anymore for whatever reason. Who knows? But clearly there's something going on. This was a photo that Tyler Erb shared to his Facebook page. You can see here from the victory lane photo here, standing in front of Madden's car. Like, clearly these guys are having words with each other. Absolute excellent photo. I don't know who took this, but great job. Obviously, Turbo's loving how Marler is just chilling right here. He says, Abercrombie and Fitch, sign this man now. Straight male model in the front stretch. As like Madden and Thornton are just, they look like they're about to go all right there. So, but nothing happened on the front stretch or in the where the victory lane is there. Nothing happened. But we did get this report here from DirtOnDirt.com's Kevin Kovac. He says that following the finish, quote, the pair exchanged words in victory lane, and later in the pits, they were separated by security. I had someone inform me who was there tell me that a crew member for Madden informed Thornton that he didn't belong there. So I'm assuming they were either at Thornton's trailer or at Madden's trailer. It's unclear. I didn't get that information. But then that crew member then shoved Thornton, and then security was then called to intervene. So that is what I was told. But clearly seems like this is going to be settled probably on the track at Sonoya is what it sounds like, if we believe what Ricky Thornton Jr. had to say. And obviously things escalated following that post-race interview there. Like, this was after the post-race interview, clearly like some words being exchanged, and then obviously some shoving. At least there was at least one shove that occurred, at least according to my source. So looks like we're going to have a decent rivalry here between Chris Madden and Ricky Thornton Jr. Definitely makes for interesting headlines, interesting storylines, given the fact that Madden did indeed crew chief for Thornton for the second half of the season with him over there at Kohler Motorsports. And now the two are clearly unhappy with each other, especially the way that they were racing each other here this weekend at the World Finals at the dirt track at Charlotte. But let me know what you guys make of this. And then I just want to go back. If you understand what Thornton is saying about the left side and everything like that, if there's some kind of reference to that I've completely missed, please let me know in the comments below.